Today, I am running through my top 5 modern turntables. My number 1 pick may surprise you. Also, stick around to the end of this video because I will share my thoughts on those all-in-one suitcase-style record players. Let's get started. Hi, my name is Frank. Welcome back to Channel 33 RPM, your channel for vinyl gear and more. Now, the views expressed in this video are all my opinion. Your opinion may differ. Feel free at any point to weigh in the comments below. Also, for the sake of simplicity, all dollars quoted in this video are US dollars.
Channel 33 RPM.
Number 5 on my list is the Audio-Technica LP60X. The LP60X is a fully automatic belt drive turntable that has proven to be an extremely popular entry-level record player. And with the retail price of about $120, it presents an affordable opportunity to get into the world of vinyl. What I like about the LP60X is that it's a no-frills, easy-to-set-up, and easy-to-use turntable for the novice record collector. And as a bonus, it comes with a built-in switchable phono preamp. This means you can basically plug the LP60X into any home stereo or set of powered speakers and you are good to go. You don't have to worry about having a dedicated phono input or an external preamp. Now, the record player does feel a bit cheap and plasticky, but at this price point, what do you expect? The LP60X won't win any hi-fi awards, but it sounds decent and offers good value. At number 4, we have the Orbit series of turntables from U-Turn Audio. U-Turn Audio offers a range of turntable options. I have reviewed both the entry-level Orbit Basic, which retails for $200, and the upper-end Orbit Special, which sells for about $500. Both perform well and offer excellent value. As you go up the product line, you get a better cartridge and a better platter, but all come with an optional phono preamp. What I like about these fully manual belt drive turntables is that they are easily upgradable. If you get the lower end basic, for example, you can upgrade it over time with a better platter and a better cartridge. Also, these Orbits are essentially plug and play turntables. You don't have to fuss with adjustments like setting the anti-skate. That's a huge bonus for those who like music and are into vinyl, but don't like to get too techie or hands-on with their gear. On the downside, queuing levers on these turntables are optional, which I find a bit odd. I also found the turntable belt to be very narrow and tricky to get on, but once you figure that out, you'll be spinning records in no time. Fluence, at number 3, has made a big splash in recent years with its RT series of turntables. And it's no surprise why. These decks offer exceptional value to the point where many wonder how the company can offer so much for so little money. Like U-Turn, Fluence offers a range of belt drive turntables, starting at $200 for the RT80 and going up to $500 for the RT85. If you can afford it, I recommend the top end model, which I have. It comes equipped with not only an acrylic platter, but also an Ortofon 2M Blue cartridge, which on its own retails for over $200. Trust me, it sounds great. If you don't have $500 to shell out at the moment, don't sweat it. The reference line, which includes the RT82, 83, 84, and 85, all share the same main platform. This means you can upgrade things like the platter, cartridge, and stylus over time. No sweat. Compared to the U-Turn line, Fluence turntables are larger and heavier. I like that they include adjustable tracking force and anti-skate, speed control, a queuing lever, and auto stop when a record is done playing. The RT series of turntables is relatively new. I will be curious to see and hear how these hold up over time. At number 2, I give you the Riga Planner 1 turntable. The fully manual Planner 1 offers exceptional value and performance, all for around $500. Like other turntables on this list, setup is a breeze. In fact, Riga boasts that the Planner 1 can be set up in 30 seconds. I like the simplistic, tried and true design, and early reviews have given the Planner 1 top marks for sound and build quality. A couple of things to consider though, the Riga turntable does not come with a built-in preamp, so you will need to buy an external one or plug into a receiver with a phono input. Also, like the Orbit turntables, you have to manually move the turntable belt on the Riga to switch from 33 to 45 RPM. If you can live with that, the Planner 1 is a fine introduction to the world of Riga turntables and more than holds its own when it comes to entry-level hi-fi gear. And my number one pick for turntables under $500 is the Project Debut Carbon DC. The Debut Carbon DC is a fully manual belt drive turntable with a street price of around $500, give and take. Simple but classy, the DC doesn't come with all the features of, say, the Fluence RT85, but what it lacks in bells and whistles, it makes up for in quality and performance. Off the bat, you will notice the Project comes stock with a carbon fiber tone arm, typically reserved for more expensive decks. The carbon fiber material reduces resonance and in the process improves sound quality. Off the shelf, the turntable is equipped with an Ortofont 2M red cartridge. I prefer the more expensive blue, but the red holds its own, offering a sufficiently detailed, though not particularly exciting sound. The high gloss finishes on these turntables are stunning. Also, I should note, like some other turntables mentioned in this video, the DC does not come with a built-in preamp. Now, where the Project really shines is in its ability to hold a steady speed, which is essential when listening to records. In 7 years of owning my Debut Carbon, I have never had a single issue. That said, I have upgraded several components of mine over the years, adding a speed box, acrylic platter, and a better cartridge. If you want all those features off the bat, consider upgrading to the $600 Project Debut Carbon Evo turntable. Otherwise, you can't go wrong with a standard, tried and true Debut Carbon DC. This turntable gets top marks for sound, performance, build quality, and good looks. I don't want to give the impression that this is an exclusive list. There are plenty of really good turntables under $500. In fact, that $400 to $500 range is really a sweet spot when it comes to modern turntables. That's when these things start to get really good. In addition to the brands I've mentioned, look out for turntables by Denon, Marantz, and Music Hall, among others. Also, as promised, a quick word on those all-in-one suitcase-style record players. You know those ones, the Crossleys and all that. People often ask if they're any good and would I recommend them. No, the build quality is not very good, and no, I would not recommend them, mostly because they really don't sound very good. I think the stories of them destroying records, those have been exaggerated over the years. All this said, I'm not going to be critical of anyone who buys an all-in-one suitcase style record player. A lot of people dig them, and if they happen to get you into vinyl, I don't see what the big deal is. I gave my kids one of those record players, and they love it. If you want to learn more about some of the turntables in this video, check out my gear playlist where I do some in-depth reviews. Otherwise, I hope you dug today's video. Until next time, keep on spinning.